Well, thank you all very much. I see a lot of new faces, and I think the buzz at the cocktail hour was about as buzzy as we've ever seen. So thank you all for being here and braving the weather. The language of tonight's resolution, I think I might have done it a little differently had I known about the Bernie Madoff scandal. But the art world does have its share of forgeries and its share of dealers who fake provenances and its instances where things are stolen from consignors. So there are bad apples in every basket. But that's not really the thing that interests us and why we picked the language of this debate. It's really the ethical issues revolving around two ideas, and one idea is secrecy, and the other idea is manipulation. When you buy a work of art at auction, it seems like a very open process, but there are a lot of secrets. You don't know what the reserve is. You don't necessarily know the source or the meaning of the estimates that are attached. There's no real disclosure about guarantees. If the auction house has made a deal with favored third parties, you don't know about that. What's described as a buyer's premium is sometimes rebated to the seller or used for other purposes. Again, pretty obscure, a lot of secrets in that process. And the second element, I'd say, is market manipulation. As an example, the graphic symbol we used for tonight's debate was Damien Hirst's skull encrusted in diamonds that was widely publicized to have sold for $100 million, which I believe is the highest price ever paid for a work by a living artist. Well, it turned out subsequently that the purchaser was none other than Damien Hirst and his dealer, to the tune of at least 50% of the syndicate that was buying it, and who knows how much in reality. In the recent auction of Damien Hirst's work, he or his dealer was a buyer of a lot of key lots. And another example is the Warhol market, which is dominated by a family called Mograbi, textile merchants from Colombia, who own 800 Warhols and are prominent buyers of all of the prime examples that they bid up at auction. So it's also very, very common practice for dealers to bid up the auction prices of works of art by artists in their stables, but dealers get very angry at clients who sell at auctions, often blacklisting those clients. So when I'd like now to turn back to the stock market. In the 1920s, there were syndicates of sophisticated investors who would quietly accumulate stock and would then sell the stock back and forth to each other at ever-increasing prices in order to give the unsuspecting public the sense that there was a buoyant and lively market. When the public came in, the insiders would quietly sell. Well, that conduct became illegal. And it's been illegal for the last 60 or 70 years. And in a way, when the art market is advertising prices at auction that are not real, that are intended really to deceive people about the true state of the market, that's a very similar kind of manipulation. The questions for tonight are, how endemic is that? How common is it? Should those kind of practices be illegal? And finally, does the art market operate in a generalized sense with high ethical standards or not? And we have a very, very distinguished panel, and it's now my pleasure to turn the evening back to John Donvan.
Thank you. May I invite one more round of applause for Robert Rosenkranz, who makes these evenings possible. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another Intelligence Squared U.S. debate from the Caspary Auditorium at the Rockefeller University. I'm John Donvan, your host and moderator, and the motion before us tonight is this: the art market is less ethical than the stock market. We have six panelists, all from the New York and London art world. We know that we have many members of those of the New York and London art worlds in the audience tonight as well, which makes for an even more interesting evening, because this debate actually is a contest. It is a contest of wit and logic and ideas and facts and argument and, most of all, persuasion. These six panelists are here to persuade you to their point of view on our motion, which I will state once again: the art market is less ethical than the stock market. In the course of the evening, you will hear from the panelists in three rounds. In the opening round, each side will speak in alternately for 7 minutes apiece. There will be no interruptions. They have clocks that tell them when their time is up. If they exceed that time, I will step in and pull reins on them. After that, we will have about a 40-minute section where the debaters actually will debate head-to-head, and that will be mixed up somewhat with questions from me and also questions from you, the audience. And as I asked you earlier, when you ask questions, please really think in terms of crafting a question. It is a challenge. It is an artistic challenge. And the signature to a question is a question mark at the end of the statement. And finally, each of the panelists at the end of the evening will be able to sum up for 2 minutes, and at that point we will find out who the winner is. Now, what we're going to ask you to do, we're going to poll you twice during this evening. Once now, as you come in off the street to see where you stand on the motion, and once again at the end of the evening so that we can see how many minds were changed. So if you turn now to the keypads that are at your seats, and I explained this earlier, but for the new arrivals, there are a series of buttons. Please pay attention only to buttons number 1, 2, and 3. Those are the ones you need to register your opinion on this motion. The motion, again, the art market is less ethical than the stock market. Push number 1 if you agree, number 2 if you disagree, and number 3 if you remain undecided. If you think that you've pushed the wrong button, just correct yourself and our system will record only your last entry.